And we're back for some more Pillars of Eternity, The White March, Part 2. I was supposed to follow this lady, forget her name, down to the fishery. But before we do that, let's just take a quick look here at the hot springs and go to Thiersch's house.
Got it.
We can't actually look at it. We used to be able to. It's just kind of here. Alright. I'm pretty sure there was a description for it at some point. I'm not done yet, damn it! At least back home you could get a good Valian wine. Hunter, hunter. They look armed for, ready for bear, don't they? Thank you. Well, you are alive. Okay, they look like they were ready for battle. I wish you luck on your travels, friend. Why, thank you. There's nothing in there, is there? Rat nest. Huh. There might be something in here. Oh, some meat. Nah, we don't need that. And we can't travel back here. Alright, let's go in. Alright, let's see if Thiersch has anything to say. Let's look at his stuff first. The shaft of each spear is splintered and broken, each of them held together only by tightly bound leather straps. These necklaces have been made from the teeth and claws of various predators. Wolves, bears, and lions. Now, I think we can unlock this. We just can't...
I can do that.
Take from it.
That's settled.
Which is good, because then we get 120 experience. Worth it. Thiersch, or Thiersch, or whatever.
Welcome. Have a seat by the fire if the cold's gotten into your bones.
Okay, just to re-familiarize ourselves, we're going to ask him some questions. I'm not going to read his soul, however.
Coming to your elders for advice, is it? What can I do for you?
What can you tell me about Stalwart? Didn't have a speck of hope you'd get the battery open, but you've done it. Truth, for some reason this is gray, like he's not saying it, but he is, isn't he? Truth is, between the White Forge and all Renegild's plans, I think we have a fair chance. That's more than we've had in a long time, all thanks to you. What can you tell me about the ogres? Only that they've been coming down in force, again and again, trying to drive us out or kill us outright.
The moment we started looking into Durgan's battery, it was like we'd kicked a hornet's nest.
That was random. Heard you managed something like a civil agreement with Berrigan's clan. Hope you have some kind of plan there. They're not very good at alliances. I think we've dealt with them. Why is the hunting so poor?
It's been a colder season than usual, and the elk herds aren't faring well. We're stuck fighting with the ogre clans and the wolves over what's left. With Suldren gone, gods mend him, perhaps the village will stand a better chance. What a price to pay.
Has the legacy struck Stalwart as well?
It has. We had some hope in the early days that we'd be spared, isolated as we are. That hope died in a hurry.
For those who don't know or have forgotten, the legacy is... I'm pretty sure it has to do with the children being born with no souls. And as they grow older, they become basically savage beasts inside the bodies of young kids.
Not everyone's been so unlucky, of course. You'll see a few pampered sprats around.
Okay, so some people have been successful to have souls in their kids, which is a good thing. Treating them like precious stones won't see them grow up any faster, if at all. The sudden sorrow in his features belies his soft laughter. You must have some interesting hunting stories.
Once, perhaps. Now I have only the one tale. We both know how it ended. I would sooner not recount it.
Well, it's too bad, because I pretty much forgot it. I think it had something to do with a giant bear or something? I'm not sure. There's only inclined his head in acknowledgement. tapping out his pipe. Farewell. All right. That ended suddenly. Let's go meet what's her name, Diana Fishery. Actually, we have to go and do that, or yeah, okay. And we'll speed it up. And look at him go. Looks like a long green slinky or something. Yeah, Kern is upset. Alright, so there's Nesta. That's her name. Gods, it's freezing out here. Let's get this over with quickly. I'd go inside the fishery, but that smell. Ugh. I'm also regretting having the fish stew at the inn. One of the fishermen said they found a body in one of the barrels once. Oh, that was our monk who we have hanging out at Cadnua now. According to the town's records, the fishery doesn't export much these days. Why do they keep it open? It's an unnecessary drain on resources better spent on the White Forge and the mines. Closing down the fishery could help convince the investors that Starwood is serious about maintaining its prosperity. True, true. Self-reliant. Foster goodwill and cooperate with future reserves. The fishery helps keep Starwood self-reliant. Less expense in acquiring outside food. That's a pragmatic answer. I'll say that the fishery remains open should any objections against it be raised. I spoke briefly with Grind, the head fisherman. A rather shady fellow, wouldn't you say? Is he the type that should be in charge? You're beginning to waste my time. I'm sorry, I didn't mean any offense. She bows. I'll be heading over to the Storwick Mines next. My clients are concerned about the security and safety of the mines. Meet me there when you're ready. Meet Nesta in the Starwood Mines in Starwood Village. Okay, so that brings us there to the mines, which I don't recall. We may or may not have been there during White March Part 1. She'll be waiting for me near the foreman's office. I guess that's inside the mines? Watch the little slinky go. We still gotta head back here. See if we can get any weapons or armor from Maneha. I was supposed to check the stash first to see if we have anything good for her. Is she... Wait. Not completely clear on that. Is she in there? Scattered spots of yellow powder blotch the surface of the barrels. The stench of sulfur hangs in the air. Lumps of iron ore fill the cart. I guess she's in there. She's in there, man. Gamel?
No! Please! You've got the wrong man! I don't remember any of this!
That's not Nesta.
We'll get the truth out of you soon enough. Take him away!
What's going on? The truth about what? Foreman Ismi. That's an interesting color there. A stern-faced woman approaches you. Her already impressive frown is only emphasized by her slight underbite. She folds her arms. I'm sorry I got an underbite. It's not my fault. Nesta mentioned someone would be coming along. Be careful where you wander. These mines are still crawling with all sorts of pests. We haven't been able to clear them out yet. Great. I hope I can remember combat. Of course, you have experience with that sort of thing, I hear. Guess we have you to thank for opening the battery. I'm Ismi, the foreman. We've been keeping busy around here since the battery's fires were lit. A little busier than I'd like sometimes. What's going on here? Things are hard enough around here with the local wildlife. Last thing we needed to deal with was a murder, of all things. Tell me about this murder. You probably saw Gamel getting carted off. Found him by the body of another miner, Semeth. We've lost quite a few miners recently. Most just vanished. Semeth's the first corpse to stick around. We may have caught Gamel, but we haven't been able to find the bodies. You know, if anyone can help us put all this to rest, it's you. I'd like to be able to give these miners' families some answers, even if it's bad news. Tell me about Gamel. Don't know him so well. Certainly never pegged him for a killer. I'd say you're better off questioning him yourself. See if he'll tell you where he stashed the corpses. I have a feeling he didn't do it. What do you know about this victim, Semeth? Poor Semeth. His body's up the tunnel to the east. Folks say you've got a knack for making sense of corpses. Like the Dunreed Row sorts, right? I'll look into it. I appreciate the help. We certainly need it. I have a few questions for you. Sure thing. What do you want to know? Why are these mines so important? The demand for ore has gone up since you opened the battery. Everyone wants their own shiny piece of Durgan steel. Thing is, the battery was hit pretty hard by the tremors. With the battery mines collapsed, we're the only game in town. So how are the mines holding up? The beasts aren't going away anytime soon. Now that Gamel's gone and killed somebody, folks are probably starting to think we should just abandon these tunnels again. About those missing miners. Yeah, I had a feeling it was the same questions. Well, we need to outfit, what's her name? Neha first. Gamel, a worker in the Stalwart Mines, has been apprehended for murder. Foreman Ismi believes that Gamel may also be responsible for a recent string of disappearances. She asked me to look into the disappearance of several miners. She suggested I start by questioning Gamel, who is being held in the foreman's quarters, just left to the entrance to the mines. Ismi mentioned that the body of one of the victims, Semeth, could be found in the tunnel to the east. Okay. Gamel. Semeth. We gotta give her stuff. That is not inventory. Let's see if we have anything of use. Leaden key robes. No, that's not gonna do anything. Fovano's boots. Sure, for now. You know, we need more than that. For some reason I thought we had more. We gotta head to... Good work at the battery. Guess we owe you our livelihoods. Thank you, and you might be right.
Mila, where have you got to this time?
Well, who said that? If you're looking for Mila, tell Royce I haven't seen her. Someone needs to get a better eye on that girl. To keep a better eye on that girl. Well, I don't know where she is. Okay. We'll continue. Almost there, right? We passed it. Okay, it's working. Alright, let's see if we have anything better. Boots. I'm gonna look at this though. The colored coat. Grants wicked briars when endurance drops below 51%. Plus 4 damage reduction, etc. The Right Lord Toral Tannering found himself in the unenviable position of being caught in the war between two branches of his own family, fought over hunting rights to certain lands that were jointly owned. While most family members found it easy to choose a side, Laurel could not bring himself to take up arms against anyone in his large extended family. He had this brigandine decorated in two tones, each representing the opposing family banners, and had the local spell rites imbue it with the power to raise a wall of briars, which he hoped to use to keep the sides divided on the battlefield. When the two sides met in combat, he rode out to the center of the battlefield, raising briar patches and waving to both sides, calling out for them to stop their mad feud. Unfortunately, his decorative brigandine had the opposite effect of what he intended, and each side read it as being the uniform of the other. Oh my god, he was felled by a rain of arrows from both directions. When his family realized he had died, they put their battle on hold and discussed peace. Then they began to argue about where Laurel would be buried, and the feud began anew. In any case, we're not going to get this. I'm pretty sure I'm keeping her armor. I just need boots, a belt, a helm. I want the stag helm. Immunity to stuck. This is pretty neat. What's the Seal of Faith? Oh, this is for priests. Wizards. I might give her this belt. Plus 25 defense against charm, confuse attacks. Plus 10 defense against dominated attacks. Plus 10 concentration. Belts of evasion. Plus 2 reflex. This is a sanguine plate that helps you. Yeah, I'm not. She already has resistance against that, so she's not going to be knocked down as much as other people would. These are just regular helms that don't really do anything. They're all 10 copper. Or 75 copper. Alright. Reflex helps against area of effect attacks. Dodging out of the way of. Yeah. Let's get those. What about this? The Spellward Amulet. Plus 10 defense against spells. That's the Whitaker Hood we used to disguise ourselves. Which didn't help because we brought our friends with us. Belt of Bountiful Healing. Only usable by Ranger, yeah, so let's not get that. Let's make sure this is usable by anybody, actually. Yeah. Does help with athletics. A higher athletic score increases the effect of Second Wind. Characters with athletics can use the Second Wind ability to recover lost endurance. Resolve. Mental intimidation, leadership, and convincing performances. Maintain concentration, contribute, yeah. Out of these, I think I'll get this helm. Although the stag helm is athletics and dexterity. Yeah, let's get the stag helm then. And what else did we need? Some kind of ring? This is a priest-only ring. Do we need gloves or something? The only kind of weapon I would get her, because she already has weapons, would be something unique, which I am not finding. All right. In any case, Favano's boots will put back here. Stag helm. She looks funny now. We do need gloves, which I haven't found. And a ring or two. That would go there. Why did we switch to her? I'm actually curious. I think it's maybe only she can wear it. No, anyone can. Huh. It's like she wanted me to put it on. I need gloves and... I don't know. If I get just plain old gloves, will that help against anything? I think they have plain gloves, but I don't know if that helps with AC or anything, and I don't see them yet. Ring of the Salonin, which is right, wizard. Yes, it's not helping here. Alright, let's go. On the way back to the mines, I'll go to Durin's wagon anyway and see if he has anything like that. Alright. Ultimate Hat of Alluring Perfection. This is pretty nice. Unfortunately, it's minus 2 intellect and resolve. Trading for might and constitution. I guess it's good for a fighter type, then. This hat was designed by an apprentice wizard who sought to create the perfect magical accessory. He spent weeks binding spells and wards to the material, but when he finished, he felt that it looked rather plain. He wanted to strike an imposing figure for peers and rivals, so he spent a few more days adding embellishments. A crest of feathers behind one ear, a band of silk around the brim. It was an improvement, but it also showed the young wizard how poorly he'd chosen his original color scheme. So he spent a few more days experimenting with other shades in suede, satin, and leather. While the poor young apprentice obsessed over his hat, his peers continued studying spells and hexes. By the time of his first duel, he had assembled a fantastic wardrobe, but forgotten many of his spells. His performance ended in his budded career in magic most ignominiously, but he went on to become a successful tailor. Ring of Deflection. Well, that's pretty neat. That's actually really helpful. What does she have now? She has the belt of healing or something. Riona's buckle, yeah. Gauntlets of accuracy. Plus 5 accuracy. I like the gauntlets and the ring. And scrolls and orbs. Potions. We have plenty. Any other rings? Because she has, well, although she has 10 fingers, I guess she only has 2 ring fingers, and that's all she can use. Ah, good enough. Let's go question this guy. Been having some tough times in the mines, he says.